Hello and welcome to the channel. Hell Let Loose has recently released version 6, and with that update we gain a few new features: new map, Utah beach update, new customizations and overhauled ballistic system. We also get the commander ability for recon planes, and on top of that we have two new ground vehicles, the Puma and the Greyhound. With a new upgrade to the Unreal Engine, optimizations and smooth gameplay should be quite evident in this new release, but for now, let's get boots on the ground here and have a look at the map and see what we think. Let's go. Hürtgen Forest encompassed around 50 square miles of rugged, densely wooded terrain along the German-Belgian border south of Aachen, the first major German city to fall to the Allies. The area was thickly laced with mines, barbed wire, and concealed pillboxes with interlocking fields of fire. The American First Army was tasked with capturing the forest to secure the right flank of the advancing 7th Corps, to prevent the Germans from mounting counterattacks from its concealment, and to attack a large portion of the Germans' fixed fortifications of the Siegfried Line from the rear. So immediately we can tell on this map it's got a different vibe, a different feel to the other maps. It almost feels as though this is autumn, with the wind blowing through the trees here and a lot of the autumn leaves on the ground turning into a real muddy, squelchy mulch underfoot, which must have been just absolute energy sapping for infantry on both sides, and leaving clear tracks here in the mud for the armour and the anti-armour in order to be able to hunt them down. As with all the maps here in Hell Let Loose, the attention to detail is just incredible. And I think a lot of the times when players come onto these maps and get engaged in the combat, you don't really take the environments and the attention to detail to heart, really, because you're that focused on staying alive and getting involved in engagements and combat. But if you actually stop and just look around at the incredible items that are here out on the field scattered and laid around, you really are going to see some just incredible things that make these maps just feel realistic and believable. And I don't get that from a lot of other World War II shooters. Here we got one of the field guns, or the pack gun is that, here out in the field. And this map has a real sense, as you will see as we get further up into this location, that the battle has almost been through and finished. That's how it feels when you walk around this map empty. It's got a real, how can I put this? You can almost taste the exhaust fumes. You can almost feel the cold air and the mist as it rolls through the forest as you get further up. These maps are just absolutely fantastic. And as we push up further on, we'll have a look at some interesting locations and also see where the infantry could possibly get some great lines of sight, especially with the MGs and the tanks on this map are going to have to be really rather careful, because there are lots of places for the infantry to be able to hide here in the dark, misty shadows. As we tab our way across one of the farmlands here, these are the things I'm talking about, the random fence posts that have been knocked down here, and over on the left we have a kind of dry stone wall that's been knocked through, and there are wheelbarrows and spades here where they've obviously been fixing it with the posts. This is what I'm talking about with these maps, the believability of them is just incredible, and it's only when you actually come into an empty map and have a look around, you'll start to notice these things, as we just seem to take them for granted. But compared to other games, I think Hell Let Loose absolutely leaves the majority, if not quite a few, AAA games in the dust. So let's just head up here into the barn. Chances are there are not going to be many people to fight in here, so they didn't really need to add any. But as you can see, the lights are still working. We have the tractor because we are on farmland. And up here, as we go further up, it looks like some of this area has been shelled and bombed. And we will push further up and have a quick look. Mired in combat in Hürtgen Forest of Germany, an American soldier wrote on December the 5th, 1944, that the road to the front led straight and muddy brown between the billowing greenery of the broken topless firs. And in the jeeps that were coming back, they were bringing the still living. The still living were sitting in the back seats, and some were perched on the back seats, and others were sitting facing forward on the radiators because the jeeps were that crowded. You could see the white of their hasty bandages from far off, and there were others of the still living who were on the stretchers strung from the front seats to the back and on the radiators too. And the brown blankets came up to their chins. Overhead, the sky was grey. So here we are heading through now from the villages in the lower part of the map up towards the actual hill where most of the conflict and the combat will take place. And if I actually go down into prone position here, I can tell you as a hiker, a wild camper, the ground here just feels very, very realistic with the wet leaves, the damp ground. It's got a really fantastic feel to it. And as you can see, the ground mist and the fog on this map gives a real sense of a real eerie feeling of not knowing where the enemy is dug in, and shadows and rocks just pop out in your peripheral vision thinking it's a helmet or an infantry that's actually hiding. But what we're going to do from here is we're going to be pushing up now, and what you'll find is there is only one route in and out really for the armor. So if there's any armored sections going to be coming up here, they're going to be having a real difficult time. Now, as we get up to near the precipice here, you're going to notice that the infantry that are at the top are going to have a real advantage shooting down and throwing grenades down, but they are going to be skylining themselves up at the top. And if the infantry can spread out well enough, you're going to be able to attack this from quite a few locations until you get to the very peak. Just as you think you're getting over the first brow, as you can see, there is another steep hill all the way up here, and this is where the armor is going to have to be very, very, very careful, because all it takes is a couple of mines on this road and some of the AT hiding behind these log stands and anywhere along these embankments, both left and right, you're going to be in a world of pain. As we head up further up to the very top here, we'll start to see one of the massive radio communication towers, and we'll also see the barbed wire coming into place, which will funnel a lot of the infantry. If you've got a good squad leader and you can dig in and get in a good defensive position up here, it's going to be quite difficult for the advancing opposite army in order to be able to get up and take this capture point. I can't imagine having to fight over days working your way up these hills under constant combat duress. We really, really don't have any idea what those people went through on both sides. It must have been terrifying, and the bloodshed and the death here must have been just simply immeasurable. As we get near the very top, there are lots of these locations, and the attention to detail again here in Hürtgen is just incredible. It's almost like when you look through these little peepholes and these gun emplacements, it's almost like it's photorealistic in many places. You can almost feel the mud on your boots as you run up here. As we get further up now, we're going to start seeing the barbed wire just up ahead in front of us, and we will be able to see the radio tower, as you can see, up at the top there again. And as I mentioned, if you've got a good squad leader and you can get your defences in here, anti-personnel mines, maybe an MG emplacement up here, you're going to be in a fantastic position. As you can see, a lot of the surrounding area around here is covered with barricades and barbed wire. I did mention at the beginning of this video about the new vehicles, the Puma and the Greyhound, and I thought rather than trying to squeeze everything into this one video, I will do quite an in-depth video on both of those and give you a little bit of history on the vehicle and its usage in World War II. So if that's of interest to you, please leave a comment, subscribe, like and share, or even just leave me something, a little bit of positive feedback. That's all I need, and I will be more than gladly delving into the World War II history books and giving you some information on both those vehicles. The Battle of the Hürtgen ended in a German defensive victory, and the whole offensive was a dismal failure for the Allies. The Americans suffered 33,000 casualties during the course of the battle, which ranged up to 55,000 casualties, including 9,000 non-combat losses, and it represented a 25% casualty rate. The Germans, on the other hand, suffered heavy losses with 28,000 casualties, and many of these were non-combat and prisoners of war. The surprise German Ardennes offensive caught Allied forces off guard. The Germans attacked with nearly 30 divisions, including the 1st SS, the 2nd and the 12th Panzer divisions, with the northernmost point of the battlefield centred on Moscow. They forced a large salient into the American lines, almost 60 miles deep and at its maximum extent. However, the Germans never came close to their primary objective, the capture of Antwerp. The Ardennes offensive came to a complete halt in early January, when German forces in the northern shoulder of the bulge were blocked by a strong American defence, the destruction of bridges by American engineers, and a lack of fuel. In early February, American forces attacked through the Hürtgen Forest for the final time, and on 10th of February 1945, the road down was taken by American forces, and the forest itself was not cleared until the 17th, when the 82nd Airborne Division reached the Rohr River. So that brings us to our end of the tour on this map. There are so many locations and capture points that really I didn't want to do a full overview of the entire map, because part of the experience is for you to get out there and enjoy it. Yes, this map is gritty and dirty, and as I mentioned, there is a real believability not only about this map but all the maps in Hell Let Loose, and I think you're going to find this fantastic. It is a infantry heavy map, and the armoured sections are going to have a very difficult time getting up here and actually staying alive long enough to be effective. So you are going to have to be rather, well, shall I say, you need to be rather tactical. Of course, the commander can now call in two new vehicles, including the recon, which enables one of the participants to be able to take photographs and transmit that information to the team and the commander. And I will be covering that vehicle in detail in another video. But for now, let's have a look at the new character skins and have a look at some of the other new features added in this new update. Now, there is a new ballistic system in the game, which means that bullet drop is now in for all the infantry sections. So if you find that you're not quite getting laser hits and instantly hitting somebody at the other side of the field, well, now you'll know why. As you can see on screen, we've now got new faces, including Kojak here on screen, and these look a lot more believable than the gormless faces that we had in the previous alliteration. And we will have a look at some of the German faces as well. They all seemed to look a little bit like Prince Harry in the previous one, and none of them looked like they were battle veterans at all, even though a lot of the infantry during World War II was around 18 and under 20. As you can see, here are some of the faces. We've got Enric, we have Hans, we have Karl, we have Amadeus, and on the end we have Otto. So new skins, new places, new vehicles, it's all here in the new Hell Let Loose update. So if you've enjoyed this video, please leave your comments and feedback in the box below. Give me some love, like and share, and maybe leave a suggestion on what you think we should look at in the future. Anything in particular, anything you'd like me to look at or give a little bit of history on while we look at some of the Hell Let Loose footage, then I'll be more than gladly produce it for you in thanks for your support. So that's it. We've had our boots on the ground here at Hill 400. I hope you've enjoyed everything. I shall see you no doubt in some more Hill at Loose, and possibly, just possibly, a little bit of postscriptum. Thanks for watching. Respect to all those out there, alive, fallen, and anybody involved in World War II. Some of us don't forget, and some of us will constantly salute you. Thank you. Bye-bye.